Well, hello everyone. Today we're going to look at the first part of chapter 4, which is going to be involving cellular metabolism. So we talked about metabolism. We said it was the sum of all chemical reactions of the body. Now, in the cell, we also have metabolism. We call it cellular metabolism. And just like metabolism for the whole body, this is just the sum of all the chemical reactions occurring in the cell. Now, just to remind you, we have two types, anabolic and catabolic. We talked about this earlier in one of the previous chapters. Anabolic or anabolism is when we take smaller molecules and build them to larger ones. In chapter 2, when we were looking at the chemical reactions, we called it a synthesis reaction. And so synthesis reactions and anabolism are the same thing. Catabolism, which is breaking things down, so I take a larger molecule and break it into smaller molecules. Again, as it says, this one releases energy. This is what we call decomposition reactions back in chapter 2. Now, as I've said multiple times, everything that goes on in your body is about this most amazing molecule, H2O, water. And so water is the driver for everything. We talked about it with pH and how it's pH is simply a balancing act of the two parts of water, hydrogen, hydroxyl. And we're going to see that in anabolism and catabolism, it is all about water as well. So in anabolism, again, when I'm building something up, which is a synthesis type of reaction, it is done by dehydration synthesis. It means I am removing water. And when I remove water, I am building bridges. So we'll see this in just a second. So, if I tried my hand at drawing with this, what I'm going to do is remember the A plus B equals AB. All right, woo. So again, bear with me here, because it kind of is easier when you can see it, but it'd be easier if I could draw it out with like a whiteboard. So I've got a hydroxyl on one side and a hydrogen on the other. I take these two, I bind it together and remove them, and I form the bond between the AB there. So I am building something by removing water. And then on the opposite side, catabolism, the breaking down, is done by hydrolysis. And if I mispronounce it, I would say hydrolysis. And again, remember, lysis means to break down. Hydro means with water. So I'm breaking it down with water. So where this one is, I'm removing water. If I'm using this one up here, if I'm removing water, on the opposite side, if I have this a reversible reaction, I'm going now this way, what I'm doing is I'm breaking this down because I'm taking this water and I'm jamming it into this little bond, breaking it and putting one hydrogen here and one hydroxyl group over there. So anabolism is done by dehydration synthesis and catabolism is done by hydrolysis. Dehydration synthesis, building synthesis by removing water, dehydration, catabolism, hydrolysis, lysis, breaking down by hydro water. So this is kind of the reaction they have. And again, remember, it is a reversible reaction. It's telling you that if I'm going through hydrolysis, if I'm breaking it down, I'm taking water, this wonderful little molecule here. If I'm going this way on the equation, I'm taking water and I'm putting it in here. I'll take one hydrogen, put it there, and I take the hydroxyl and I put it there. If I want to change this and go through and now I'm going to go the opposite way, I'm going to take water and I'm going to remove this hydroxyl. I'm going to combine it with this hydrogen. And now we have water, which is here. And I have built this bond. I'm going this way. So I have synthesized, I've made something larger by removing water. So that's anabolism and catabolism and their process and how it uses, how our body uses water to drive it one way or the other. Dehydration synthesis, building by removing water, hydrolysis, lysis breaking down by using water. I hope that makes sense. Have a great day.